Hi, Rob D here with Rob B from Property Hub. Now, I love a bargain. I love saving money. And if you do too, you're watching the right video.
Yeah, because we've got the 10 cheapest places you can invest in right now.
So investing in property can be an expensive pursuit. But don't worry, we've got the 10 cheapest areas that you can invest in. The information for this report comes from Move IQ, and the numbers are based on a one-bed apartment. So if you're keen to get on your investment journey and you've got limited funds, pay attention because this list is the cheapest 10, but amongst them are some really good investment areas. Let's start with number 10.
And what a great place to start, starting with Derby, which is not only the 10th cheapest place to buy property in the UK, according to this survey, it also made our list of 2021 hotspots for property investors. So make sure you watch that video if you haven't already, that will be linked at the end. The great thing about Derby is its transport links, its university, and the strong local employment from all kinds of big companies. These are some of the same factors that seen near neighbour Nottingham top the capital growth table in 2020, and the prices in Derby are significantly lower. So potentially lots of value to be found.
Number 9 on our list is the Wirral. Now, the Wirral is a place I spent many years growing up in, so I know it very well. It's very close to Liverpool and separated by the famous River Mersey. It's got loads of green areas. Being so close to Liverpool means that there are loads of employment opportunities, and the Wirral has some beautiful areas, lots of green spaces, and is also a short distance from North Wales and Chester. So there are fundamentals galore, but property prices currently remain cheap.
At number 8, an area rather than a town, the East Riding of Yorkshire, which is an area around Hull, north of the River Humber, which includes a number of towns, but also some rural areas and some beaches as well. Although it's cheap, most areas of East Riding probably won't be suitable for buy-to-let because it is fairly rural and the tenant demand and the local employers and things like that just won't be there. However, there may be pockets where supply is relatively low and demand is strong because it's a popular and pleasant place to live. So if it's an area that you know well or get to know well, there could be value there.
Number 7 on our list is Kirklees, and Kirklees is another area, and within that area lies Huddersfield. Huddersfield is a town that sits almost directly between Leeds and Manchester, so there are fundamentals galore. It's just off the M62, so the transport links are good as well. So with plenty of employment opportunities, good transport links, and cheap property prices, means that you may want to consider Kirklees as your next investment area.
At number 6 is Wakefield. When we talk about investment areas, we talk a lot about transport because transport links are so important, and Wakefield really couldn't be better served. As well as being just off the M1, it's also on the main train line into London and is commutable to Leeds. And because prices are so much lower than in Leeds, it's becoming very popular with commuters. There's also a lot going on in Wakefield in its own right. So if Yorkshire is your area, Wakefield, definitely worth a look.
Number 5 on our list is Sandwell. Now, Sandwell is not near the beach, as you may have expected from the name, but actually in the West Midlands, which actually makes it more surprising because many people would assume that property prices in the West Midlands wouldn't make our top 10 list. But yet, here we are. Sandwell is not too far from Birmingham, so again, lots of fundamental opportunities there, and it benefits from good transport links. So if you're looking for a cheap place to invest in the West Midlands, check out Sandwell.
At number 4, somewhere that is near the beach, North Tyneside. North Tyneside is on the east coast and just to the northeast of Newcastle upon Tyne. Property prices there are very cheap. Is it a good place to invest though? Possibly, if you know the market well and you're in search of high yield. But be careful, you're unlikely to see much capital growth because the northeast is furthest behind in the property cycle anyway. So even in Newcastle upon Tyne, property prices have been slow to move. But in an area that's outside Newcastle and not as strong economically, you're going to be waiting even longer for that growth. But still, if cheap is what you're after, there's only 3 cheaper.
We're now entering our top 3, and next on the list is Bradford. Bradford has possibly unfairly got a poor reputation. Although Bradford has lots going for it. There are many employers in the area, property prices, obviously, are very cheap, and it benefits from close proximity to both Leeds and Manchester. Bradford is the cheapest area in Yorkshire that we're featuring, so if you're looking for the cheapest place to invest in Yorkshire, then Bradford is your place.
The second cheapest place to invest in property in the UK is Blackpool. You probably know Blackpool for its pleasure beach, but maybe you should know it for its low house prices as well. However, the same applies here as North Tyneside. Its relative lack of economic strength and its geographic position with relatively poor connectivity means that while prices are low, they're likely to stay low. It's not going to be somewhere where you're going to see significant capital growth. However, with its famous beach, if you are tempted by the low prices, maybe there are holiday let opportunities there.
And number one on our list, Newcastle-under-Lyme. Now, if you're expecting to bump into Anton Deck and hear people say, "Why, aye, man," you're going to be disappointed, because Newcastle-under-Lyme is actually just outside of Stoke. Now, property prices here are very, very cheap. So if you're looking to enter the buy-to-let world and you're on a low budget, maybe this is your place. Stoke is on the West Coast Main Line, so there's fast trains into London, and you're also on the M6 corridor, which means there are plenty of employment opportunities nearby as well. If you really are looking for the cheapest place to invest, well, Newcastle-under-Lyme is your place.
But should you really be basing your investment on the absolute cheapest place to invest? Of course you shouldn't. Cheap is not the same as value, and value is what you should be looking for as an investor. As we've seen, there are multiple reasons why locations that look appealing on price alone actually might not be, either because the growth isn't there or letting the property might be challenging. But there are definitely locations worth keeping an eye on in this list. Derby, Wirral and Wakefield, for example, are surprising entries on the list of 10 cheapest because they are very strong investment locations and do offer value as well as being cheap. But remember, wherever you invest, whether it's the cheapest place in the UK or one of the most expensive, wherever it is, there's going to be good areas and bad. So getting to know the area well is so important. You can make great investments and terrible investments anywhere. So by all means, use lists like this for inspiration, but make sure you really do your research.
So there you have it, the 10 cheapest places to invest. But cheapest doesn't mean best. And actually, the best are different areas. But don't worry, we've got a video that you can watch right now that tells you those best places.
Yep, so go do that and make sure you subscribe to the channel so you don't miss any more videos like these.